on television.
You gotta put on YouTube.
So just, my suggestion would be to learn this very well. Take some songs that you're very familiar with and try to put in those dominants. Those dominants are very useful. And get used to like think ahead, like, yeah, where I'm going after this. I'm going to A, so I put in the E, right? Now I'm going to the C, F, so I put in two, if I want to F, right? So think ahead if you have like a song that you... That you know very well, so it's easy for you to think ahead and put in those dominants. Next time you see a chord on the sheet and you think, oh, that's such a long way, think, can I maybe put in a two?
You want to go to, like, whatever, you go...
If you make a practice out of it, I want to go to D minor, for instance. Okay. Right, I want to go to E minor. So it's always just
the fifth
of
the next.
Yeah, the fifth, yeah.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's just practicing those together as pairs. Mm-hmm. To learn that they fit together. Hmm?
Okay, a little bit from the song, First Evening, first song with the Black Choir together.
Love.
Yeah, oh.
But you know, it's enough.
Sorry?
You take about half step to the choir.
I know it's okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is what you want to learn. Yeah. Yeah. So this is just it's actually just an A7, right? And then you put the 9 on and a 13.
Yes.
And then I leave the bass player to do this job because it's much better.
Yes, it's okay.
And then I have it here, and then I just put like 4 on top of it, 9, 5, 1. Right. This is very basic, very typical way of doing it, right?
Gershwin.
Try to open it.
Yeah.
Gershwin.
Yeah.
Gershwin. He's nice.
He's great.
Oh, I love this.
He's just like twitchy.
Oh, it's good. You know,
I have an English conductor and organ player who was, I don't know, Gershwin from the States.
It's pretty easy when you know it, right?
He knows all his works. And he's a conductor.
Yeah, when you know it, yeah. Yeah, because this is the C.
It's an opera call.
C9, right? This is the F, the 13. So it's just switching those two. Because all these tones, they go in those chords. They have different functions, of course. But they go in both. But it kind of, I like to have a bass player if I want to play something as airy as this.
No bass player, man, you got everything yourself.
Yeah. That's awesome, man. Yeah. I wouldn't do this.
I know.
Yeah, I would do like this.
The band, the band from We Have Come to Praise.
Praise him.
Oh, yeah. Praise
F. Him. Sono or a chords?
You do it as chords. Yeah.
So?
What?
Sorry. Chords. So?
Well, you can do that way, yeah. If you want to make it, or you can. Yeah. It depends on which sound you're using. I like to have like a synthesizer on it and make it.
Yeah.
And then it's a bit too much, I think, to put the chords on.
Yeah.
You don't.
No, I do.
What are you laughing at?
I'm laughing at you.
Why?
Because it says too much to put the cross on it.
Would you put the cross on? Yeah, you would.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah.
I break it up.
How?
So, like, instead of the whole chord,
yeah.
I play a piece of the chord.
Yeah. Mm.
Good.
but still diminished, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I break it up like that. Yeah, instead of the whole chord. Yeah.
Only to minimize it.
Right, to lose some space.
Come on.
He's gonna sell this video.
Yeah, we're gonna see the back of our neck and a different name in the corner.
His screen. Name?
It's me playing the video.
Yeah, you're just gonna like put speak on top of it. Yeah. We see our mouse moving.
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna play this song.
Now I've painted my skin black for the occasion. Yeah.
Just to make it sound a real more.
To make it sound more Negro. Yeah,
it's to the Russian, you say,
and the Koreans. Yeah,
it's crazy.